Hey YouTube, let's talk about wiring. Let's say this car right here is your battery box. You have your battery right in here. You have your fuse block. Right? Now it fuses. Right in there. Okay. And you notice that if I pop this off, you got some pretty thick cables here. Big thick cable right here. Go into your fuse block. And inside your fuse block, you got a variety of fuses. 10 amp, 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 etc. Alright, you notice this cable here? It's pretty thick, right? It's a thick cable. It's almost as thick as my finger. Alright. This cable can basically handle all the amperage going through here if you were to run all your accessories. Okay. So let's say that all these all total are maybe 150 or 200 amps. This cable can handle 200 amps. Okay, if, as some people have said, you were to put an inline fuse through here, there's a fuse in here, okay, but you're running a thin wire, and you have a 5 amp fuse or 10 amp fuse, well, when you start turning up all these accessories, and you're running your air conditioner, and you're running your radio, and you're running your wipers and anything else you're running in here, if that goes over, all the draw goes over 5 amps on a skinny little wire you're running through, you're going to blow that fuse. Plain and simple. So you need to check to see how much amperage your particular wire for a particular length of wire that wire can handle safely. Okay, here is a current flow in amps, an amp chart, current flow amp chart, okay? And up at the top you have the number of amps, and then here in different colors you have the gauge of wire, okay? And you either have non-critical or critical type of circuits. And what that is simply if it's a critical circuit, that means that volt drops affect an organization's ability to maintain key operations. So we're not really that concerned about this, so we're just going to go with this. And I typically use 12 gauge on my Amokan battery boxes, a 4 gang fuse with 5 amps each. So 20 amps maximum is what I'm drawing. And I can go anywhere from 0 to 20 feet. I use about 12 inches of 12 gauge AWG wire. So I'm well under the limit. There's no way I'm going to fry that wire. And what happens when you fry that wire? Basically, you have more amperage going through that wire than the wire can handle. And what happens when the amperage exceeds the capacity of the wire to handle that amperage? It starts to get hot and it might glow red. And it might ignite the jacket around the wire and something else. Now, for this mini ammo can battery box, what I'm going to do, I'm going to wire it like this. Okay, so this wire is the wire that's going to my battery. And it's going to a single terminal here and then coming out these circuits. And I got 4 different fuses and 4 circuits going out to each of my accessories and switches that are going to power my accessories. This particular wire right here is 12 gauge. This can handle 25 amps from 0 to 20 feet. Okay, and I'm going to use about 12 inches of that. This wire right here is 14 gauge, and this will handle up to 20 amps. But my fuses, I'm going to put 5, 10, 15, 20, 4, 5 amp fuses. Total amps going through here is going to be no more than 20 amps running through that wire if everything's going full boat. and I know I'm covered because I'll blow these fuses, or I could have everything running at full boat and I'm not going to fry out this wire. This wire isn't going to overheat. It's not going to cause me any problems. Okay, and it's pretty safe. Now you could see the difference here, and if you look at, you know, closely at my ammo boxes, the wires going to the battery are always thicker. This is a battery wire. This is an accessory wire. Okay, like this is a battery wire. They're the same thickness. Now another thing you could do, you can run an inline fuse between your battery and your fuse block. That's great. This is like, say, a 10 amp fuse rated for this wire. Okay, but if you're going to run 20 amps, you're going to blow this fuse, and if this is going to your battery, then you're going to kill every circuit is going to go dead on your ammo can battery box. Okay, so if you're going to use an inline fuse going from your fuse block to your battery, that's fine. It doesn't hurt. Make sure that it's not going to be under what you're going to be using total. Okay, so this is how I wire my boxes. This is how I'm wiring this in particular. If I have a more fuses on here, I'm going to use a thicker wire, maybe 10 gauge going up to 30 amps. So I am not going to exceed the total amperage on my fuse block as far as what this particular wire going to the battery is going to be rated for. The other thing I want to talk about just briefly, and I would highly recommend this to you guys, is to use silicone wire. Okay, silicone wire is rated negative 60 degrees Celsius to 200 degrees Celsius, and what that means in terms of Fahrenheit is that this is flexible and this is operational from anywhere from in Fahrenheit negative 74 degrees Fahrenheit upwards of about 392 degrees Fahrenheit. This is very good wire. Use silicone wire on your ammo box. Don't cheese out and don't cheap out on getting good wire for your ammo box. You know, build it right the first time. And if you're uncomfortable with any of this, I suggest, you know, you get a pre-engineered, something like Patriot's box. You know, that's all ready to go. It's got built-in inverters, and you know, it's a turnkey solution for you, and you don't have to worry about building your own box. But you know, for something like this, you know, these boxes aren't made to really handle a lot of high amps, and you know, you should fuse them accordingly and just keep everything well within tolerances of what your wiring can handle, and you should get by okay.